Okay. Turn the box around so I can't, so I can see it again.
Because I try to do it like they say in the description, and I find this easier. So find if you mixing it really too vigorously, it forms a lot. It's gonna form no matter what. If you just patiently go around and around.
Didn't you say at one point that you'd like to let the paint sit for a while?
After you mix it up nicely. The funny thing that every color is different, it's behaving somehow differently. Some of them foam more, some less. Some have more coverage, some less. Sometimes you put like two layers and it's enough, and sometimes you need like four or five. I guess when you let it sit, it kind of deforms a little bit and dissolves. And they do sell those deforming agents, but I found
alcohol.
Them.
Just a couple of drops of alcohol.
I could try alcohol, but the deforming thing, I didn't find them terribly effective. Another crazy thing that one has happened, that when you kind of mix it really thick and let it sit, it jellifies, and then you cannot
turn it into liquid again.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So it has to be somewhat, you know, not liquid, but because if it's more like dough, then it sits overnight, and I thought it's a good thing, and it was a disaster. So I have to mix it all over again. But you also don't want to make it too thin. Basically, you know, consistency that you feel that you can control. You can always thin it more. I think.
So the paint's been sitting for an hour. The stocking material is loose enough to allow you to form a...
Yeah, because if it's like a drum, then it just rolls over. And again, some paints will dissolve so quickly that there's like nothing left, and some, when you do this, gonna be a lot of little crumbs, no matter how long you mix them. It's just kind of more like desmoclean or something, you know. And I found the stocking that works so much better than cheesecloths. So
try not to roll that table around.
So there's a little pockets of paint that is not mixed up, that is kind of mix it.
That's true.
There's like a piece of undissolved powder.
This particular one, there were not so many solids.
No, but you saw that there was a little clumps, and it's kind of helps to mix it. Okay, now I'm gonna go and rinse my paint.
Here.
I'll just pour some on the paint. This is a good container. And it should be approximately like no more than 20-25% of this stuff. Especially important if you paint it over, you know, existing paint. Well, what is this? It's pretty foamy.
Now, what are you doing?
Doesn't dry, but they don't have to like run constantly. So, first pour, just go along the cradle.
big drip coming off the end of this. Do you find it's really necessary to use the tiny brush in the moldings?
It's just easier to get to the crevices. Thank you.
So you let that dry before you do the other side of the molding on the jack rail?
Yeah, so I can flip it this way. It's a lot easier. I'll wait till this time because it dries pretty quickly. Okay. Because usually by the time you do the rounds, you can flip it and it's all safe, you know. Okay. So there's no point of like rushing it. By the time you put like one cord and
everything,
those little parts, then most need in the neck, that's the parts of the music desk.
Oh, yeah. A lot of surfaces.
You just have to be patient and, you know, like put one carefully, one surface after another, and let it seat. At least it dries quickly. Absolutely necessary. It could isolate the center of just less sanding in the end. This paint is not toxic or anything, but still, powder is.
Yeah.
Stand for this instrument?
Stand?
Yes.
You mean other than legs?
Oh, yeah, right. So, are we taking both cats together?
We're gonna try. She told me that we should immediately decide which boxes we're gonna use. So if we're gonna take the plastic box and one of the cardboard boxes, then she said we can even put both cats in one box together. And I said, well, you've never seen our big boy. But she said, if they like each other, you can do that. If not, just take the boxes, put them out tonight, and put a little treat food in there, and just let them hop into the box and go in there and sit in there or sleep in there and get to know the box as a friendly place.
Oh. Cool. Okay, so... There's little bricks. It's a lot more forgiving than any other kind of paint because it sends a powder more easily. It's supposed to wait it, so oil.
How many coats would you guess that color is going to need? Three at least.
See how transparent it is?
Yeah.
Almost impossible to tape inside there. It's just easier in the end to clean it with, you know, sandpaper if necessary.
Right, you're just going to go until this is done, right? Just without stopping, or do you put more tomorrow? Like, do you work continuously until it's done, or do you stop?
The paint is good for, you know, first couple of weeks, especially if you keep it in the fridge. I mean, for a few days, definitely, but I don't want to freeze it, refrigerate it, but it definitely doesn't last forever, so. That's why it's better to use colors from the box if you're thinking in the future you have to paint something else, just as opposed to, you know, custom color. That's why it's nice that they just expanded the color palette. You can find a lot of nice shades. So I'm trying to like mix them together. Especially if something goes wrong and you don't have enough paint, really hard to watch something that you have to mix. Last little mixing. And again, depending on the humidity, you know, sometime in the summer, you wait for quite a long time between the coats. On that spinning table, it would stop spinning.
Yeah.
I would not recommend doing everything in one session, actually, because it's usually nice to put like last coat in fresh
sanded.
Not necessarily even sanding, it depends, but just, you know, in the morning when you're not tired, when your eyes are not as tired after like putting paint all on and on and on, you know, and then it's just, it's easy to. Of course, we have to make sure that it's sand it nice and smooth. It was, but still, this I had to do like a little sand here and there, you know, in the molding to make this some really sharp corners or soften.
Distemper shots that they started with have to be redone or not. She has to ask the doctor about that. Thank you.
it's a clean line though. How far do I go? Do I go further than that?
Yeah, a little deeper than the name word. It should have one. I'll leave him a note, right? As soon as you finish this case, I'll leave him a note. Because I don't think I need to film, you know, every single thing that you... Up again.
Okay. You want me to move or just what?
You can move it back a little bit. You have enough room there. Everything else is over there now. second coat started on a few of these pieces. First coat showing some unevenness on the case, that's normal. Both sides of the lid are done now, first coat, and this one parts. Some sides have two coats, you can see the difference right there between one coat and two coats. The blue deepens as the coats build up.
Боже. 5 километров пешком? А это что ж, с чемоданами и со всем? А как она пойдет со своими вещами? And if you, God forbid, I mean, you keep it really, really light movements. If the surface is bigger, it's kind of little round movements, not because you don't want to sand it completely flat. You leave a little bit of texture evenly. I have this kind of organic look. But if God forbid you sand through, it's just really easy to go over, you know.
Now, what's the...
So you keep the moments very, very, very light. Because you don't want to send through out of the wood.
And that's 320?
Smooth.
face it, but the nature of this paint, you can make it completely smooth, but the color is never perfectly even. So it's kind of like this authentic, natural, you know, like hand ground color look. On the edge of that lid top, I accidentally sent through, well, there was a really big drip, so I had to send aggressively.
Here.
So I just repainted it, but of course I had to paint two coats.
Very, very, very light. It's just easier to keep this even texture than going circular, you know. You're gonna have to go straight and walk away. You can wear gloves, but it's just, it's kind of a rocky. From that point of paint, there's plenty left, so there's any mistakes you can mix more of. First of all, I want to examine it during the bright daylight. Put another paint here and there. Still, you're saving so much because, you know, you don't need to prime it.
Yeah, I mean,
which
you
is
started.
A huge stuff.
Yeah, and you started this yesterday afternoon and spent, what, 2 hours on it, maybe? Three? And then today you spent another?
Well, today I put in my phone but I don't know.
Well.
But still, you know. So you rub those things so they don't scratch.
How's Mama?
Just you know, see, it crumbles all the pieces in there.
Yeah. You can really hear the solids in there.
Sitting for a few days, like almost no forming.
Almost all water?
No forming. No, it's just.
So is that sound mostly from the texture of the paint, or is it from the texture of the surface and the brush rubbing against it?
I think it's texture of the surface. Both probably, because the paint definitely, you know, gets
already drying over here.
So we're gonna do the dead flower. to spread over.
So for a larger surface, you're going to dilute it with water?
Yeah.
So it looks a little whitish, but it dries clear. And here too, you do one side at a time, of course.
It's a nice surface because you can paint over it. If you want to do some decorations, you can just take acrylic paint or oil paint and just
go right over it.
Yeah, right over, or if you do gold baths, or you can put more milk paint on top. Apparently, you don't really need to use that adhesive stuff if you go over this milk paint.
If you go over this final coat?
Yeah.
Really?
That's what it says there also. The bonding agents need that it's going to bond, the milk paint is going to bond to this.
Wow.
Varnish. It's just so difficult to spread it evenly. So it's going to become in between the tone from what is
I see. At first it looks darker than it actually ultimately will be.
Yeah. paint is already dry. It's nice, actually. Looks pretty even.
This tripod sucks.
What?
This tripod sucks.
It's a nice tripod.
It's at home with my...
I think it's not as perfect as, you know, like, how much help you need. It's too much.
But for somebody who actually wanted to make it really, really flat, like you do when you're doing lacquer on key and box, let's say, where you want it to look like lacquer, you can do that, but you have to go over it with shellac.
Yeah, you can go over this with anything. You can varnish it, you can oil it, you can shellac it. So see, this is already better. A few days, and it's cures. I think fully cured, it actually takes a little while, so it's fully cured, it's like bulletproof and it's durable. Stuart was just telling me that when he worked on the boatyard, he had to strip some antique pine chests that were painted. At first they strip easily with a stripper, but if there are milk veins underneath, it just is impossible. No stripper without a stripper.
And is one coat enough of this?
So you can go over it if you like you.
Read it whenever you are. There's no loose powder
on the surface because you just painted it. It was not sanded. You still have the same
I could have used that thing kind of for harpsichord legs, but you could.
big harpsichords. I always dilute it because it's just really difficult to spread it because it's so thick.
Okay, go ahead.
You know, like maybe 20% or so. It's not.
It still has a consistency like mayonnaise when you're done.
Yeah, and it's always a little, you know, has those little lumps, but that's okay. It still makes it really a lot easier to spread. Especially, you know, when you're doing like something like French double lid, then you have to have a huge, long surface.
Can you tilt it towards me?
See, it's much. I can then show you close to the original jar.
From mayonnaise to yogurt.
I had been in the yogurt. Just looking at me.
Now, why wouldn't you just thin it from the beginning?
Yeah. best you can. Even if it's flawed, I still try to keep the direction, you know, just the wood grain. Another nice one that could not be so easy, just cleanse it with water, brushes and others.
Not to mention the smell.
Yeah. And sometimes you don't know whether how much you clean and clean and clean and clean and clean.